guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 1 of Descending Stories. So, honestly, I have no freaking idea what this show is going to be about. All I know is that a Patreon requested this, and I was like, okay, sure, what the heck? It's 2 seasons. And then when I, like, because it was funny, so last night after I, today is the first, of course, obvi. After I finished watching 2 hours of Blue Lock, and I was just like, okay, I need to go ahead and make, files of both my Patreon shows so that I can watch my Patreon stuff tomorrow when I come home from work, right? So I'm like, okay, yeah, episode 1 and 2 of both of these shows, right? Wrong! So I finished the Saki videos, and I'm like, alright, let's go ahead and do the Descending Story stuff so I can get that out of the way. And I start editing, or waiting for the file to be, you know, adding subtitles and everything. And I was like, why is this taking 15 minutes? And I look, like, at the, this was like maybe the 10 to 8 minute mark. I was like, let me look to see how long this episode actually is. This is 1 hour and 22 minutes. So, like, literally, this is freaking, as long as Oceanal and so many other animes that I think. But I think for a reason, it has to be like that. And I'm not mad at it. I mean, possibly there is a lot of information that is going to be happening. So, of course, they have to have the first episode in 1 hour. But what is sad for me, I have to cut it into parts. So, initially, of course, this will be, it'll still be all together, but of course, when you look at it, as my old subscribers know, and I know some brand new subscribers are going to be hella confused about this, so part 2, or video 2 and video 3 will still be the full episode and such, but like I said, I cut into parts. So part 1 will be from the starting point to the 49.59 mark, almost 50 minutes exactly. I'm going to stop on a mid-sentence. Then we will continue on in the next video, which will be the last 32 minutes. And then yada yada, I will talk about everything, so on and so forth, like I've done before. Instead of like how I used to do with the Demon Slayer movie. And got backlash on that over the fact that I talked and then continued with the movie, but because I enjoyed it so much and I was like, you know what, I need to voice my opinion now. I may end up doing that with this. If I do, I will let you guys know, probably before, but like, hey, I might add like 5 or 10 minutes of me talking about this real quick, and then we'll go into part 2. But that's it. But current Deja, that's all I have to say as current Deja, but I will see you guys all at the end. I hope you all enjoy it, and I will see you guys all next time. Bye for now. Alrighty, let's go ahead and get started with part 1 in 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, that's an interesting way to start. A century story about love, death, and what? Storytelling, I think I said. Was this made by Production IG? Because I'm getting feels towards that. But not, like, okay. Look at Haiku for an example, right? They have the long necks, but it's not, like, the, you know, the shading of it. Don't scare him. Oh my God. Well, I mean, you could get a job, but then it's okay. Like, you're wondering where you're gonna live at the same time too, right? That day. Fine, I'll take me in. Bye for this man. Okay. Or, oh, what, not taking advantage of your grandfather or your uncle? Oh, that. You were just a good guy who was in the wrong place at the wrong time. We need context on that, sir. But I think there's a reason why he took a chance on him. I feel like they're gonna get along in their own special way, even though I feel like she's always going to kick his behind. So, one, I already like the music of this show. It kind of gives a feel to like Spy Family and a couple of other. If you're good. That's also kind of in a way for him telling him, oh, you'll never be as good as me if you do Shinigami, but who knows? Well, bye. I can see why he was inspired to do this. Yeah, you gotta find something that suits your style. You can't always go in life copying everyone else. I feel like this is gonna touch me just much as March comes in like a lion touched me and made me cry. And we're only 16 minutes into this. That's not. The fact that he would automatically wrap her into it as well. Don't be a dick. Time out, time out, time out. Ma'am, what? Is that why I had the double suicide at the beginning of this? Nerve-wracking, but you know. He only do half Oh. Right? Please don't hurt yourself. Well, he kind of getting a little bit of a better audience. I mean, it just takes time. Oh, damn, just a candy. Oh. Drown my sorrows in candy. Or alcohol, get some beer. You know, I'm like, really? But there's gotta be some way to make it better. Should he improvise during the story? I mean, I don't think that's a good idea, but you know, hey, it's just a question I ask, you know? Just if you have the talent for it, you just do. You're right, though. Ooh, excuse me. Ooh. Yeah, but what if the next time he dies? What are you gonna do about that? Ooh. The way he is looking at him like that. He didn't have to do that. Relax, you got this. Oh, Jesus, another one. He's really working it. Like, oh, the fact that he's already had his former boss laugh, like, it's good. What do I also feel like the boss is gonna want to do something like this too? Another one getting inspired, but like, oh my God, yes, take me in too. Funny. Brand once. Oh my God. Oh. Oh my God. Of course it was. Right? Good job. Very good job. Not a full house, but still, it was good. Yeah. Right. But don't let him see your tears, babe. I'm busy. That actually would have been a good part to pause on. Well, I mean, yeah, you were in jail for how long? A little kid in the candy store. Oh, beautiful. Yeah, these two are not gonna like each other. Duh.
Alrighty.
Go ahead and pause the video, and I will see you guys in 1 second for part two. Alrighty, part two in 3, 2, 1, go.
I wouldn't go shit.
Well, it's about practicing. Really? Good job. It's funny when you look at those two, you see our current. Girl, shit, I really want to know if homeboy actually killed your dad. I think we all want to know what really happened. Are we going to probably get that? I don't know. Maybe more in season two. Are you okay with that? Great. Hey, it's something better than nothing. I would take advantage of that. I literally bit the crap out of my tongue. Wait, so her was her dad also a part of the Yakuza as well, in a weird way? You can't stop and not let her know. She has the right to know, though. What the fuck happened that night? Get it, it's not right, but still, we want to know. We have a right to know. Ooh. Okay. I do love the fact that, not once but twice in this first episode, if there is something that you need to know the definition of, it immediately tells you what it is. Probably so. She was like, take your ish and get out. Everything. Like Did you really kill her father? Bro, is she gonna torture the shit after you? That's really a confession, though, babe. At least let her try. She has determination in her eyes. That tired the hell out of him. I mean, dang, we went through the four seasons in this whole first episode. I'm not even done yet. Well, yes, most girls look like their dads. Trust me, I look like my dad. But I also look like my aunt and my uncle on my dad's side. I look like all like every single one of my dad's siblings on my dad's side. 'Cause they're all so freaking tall.
Ooh.
Yes, why? And is stiff and nervous. Yeah. I mean, he did so good in his previous one, so what happened? Also, his voice is familiar to me. I just don't know who it is. Like, between him and Mangetsu, both of their voices are familiar. The old man, I cannot, I have no idea who that is. By just thinking, it was okay. Mean, we're already seeing a rivalry between these two, but that just like confirmed it. We're gonna have a lot of arguing moments possibly between these two. Well, that ain't good. Oh, shit. I love the fact that he's working that in. Wake up! You missed literally almost everything. Plus, he's super pissed at you. Great. Because he's no! It was an accident. No. Really gonna leave him out in the snow. You're really gonna do that to him. Jesus. It's horrible. God, this only the first damn episode. You're gonna regret doing that. I have nowhere else to go. Put your big boy pants on, let's go. Maybe you can. Okay, but you have to at least try. So, what's the third promise? Honestly, it's different from most animes that I have seen at first, because like here's the one thing I'm gonna go ahead and tell you. I am not one who likes historical pieces. I feel like depending on what I am watching, and this is we're not talking about like anime, we're talking about like anything out of historical ones. I kind of get bored easily with it. Sometimes, like if I watch something that is a autobiograph, I can never say it right. autobio of someone very important that I need to know in history. Yes, I'll like it for the first like maybe 30 minutes to an hour, and then I get like super duper bored because sometimes depending on the pacing and how it's filmed and such, I get bored very easily with it. But sometimes I will, pick myself up and be like, yeah, you know what? Let me stick with it. And this is not bad. It gives me like seeing them performing gives me feels to like a one man or one woman type as show when you're looking at plays and stuff where a one person is playing a vast different amounts of characters and people are like, how can you have that range of talents? Except with this, it's more storytelling and such. But I'm not mad at that. It's really good. Very different from majority of animes that I have seen in the past. I feel like one show that was kind of my anticipated anime, I think this was winter of this year, that I really wanted to watch. I watched the first episode. I enjoyed it, but I enjoyed it a lot. Because by week two, I dropped the show. And I, of course, like I watched it for favorite seiyus and everything, but I felt like from that first episode, I felt like the quality of it was just not good. And I think, if I can find the name of it real quick, I'll let you know what it is. So give me a second. Oh God, I can't find it. There we go. Hold on. So let's go back to seasonal anime. Let's start from winter. It could be either from winter or from fall. I don't know. I gotta go back and of course look. So give me a give me a sec. Because I feel like I automatically can okay, well it's not on that. All right, let's go back to fall. Let's see. Oh shit. Excuse my language. My God. Okay, so I'm gonna have to use my anime list just to find it because the other my anime list is currently down. That's so great. I love learning that. Okay, let me see. I kind of should look it up by her name, I think. Let's try Lynn. Okay. And go to her Wikipedia. Go down the film. And it was something from last year, so I gotta look in the year 2022. Let's see. My Master Has No Tail. There we go. So, like I said, I watched the first episode of My Master Has No Tail. Enjoyed it, but I thought the pacing of it was a little slow. And that is also a historical series, but it does give me feels towards that. Like, let me look at the plot real quick. There is no plot. Oh my god. Hold on, wait. Let me look one more thing up. And if it is similar to it, who knows? Maybe I might continue watching it one day. But let's see. Raccoon Dog. Da, 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 da. Let me see if I can go on any list again. All right. So, yes, it is. It's surely like this. Okay, because literally it says right here. So, as others in her village predicted, I'm just going to call her M. I don't remember her name. Fails to deceive a single person, and she is even hunted down by an angry crowd. After seeing refugees in a theater, she stumbles upon a Rengoku performance given by the master of art, similar to this. So, this was really, this anime, My Master Has No Tail, that was my first initiative into something like this. And then because I was like, didn't really think it was that great, loved the coloring and the art style and just the seiyuu, of course, I just said no. But who knows, if I really, truly enjoy this, I might give this show a second shot. I mean, just to see. But I know definitely I would have to rewatch episode one, even though I have that first video on my channel, and then continue it on from episode two, because I think it only really, it has 13 episodes, so I could finish it in like a couple of weeks. But I'm trying not to make myself super duper busy, because I'm now going back into my busy mode where I am very hectic and crazy and stuff. And sometimes don't always have time for things. And I, like, because in my opinion, I feel like what I was doing a while ago with having two Patreon shows plus watching Pretty Cure, but now going back into two Patreon shows, Pretty Cure and Blue Lock, I felt like I was at a burnout moment. And so I think that's why I also put Pretty Cure kind of really on the side. And I was like, I need to finish these and stuff. And so sometimes I get in my head a lot. And so I'm like, ugh. So praying that does not happen. But I really enjoyed this a lot. I think this was a very interesting take on this story. I do have a lot of questions, though, on it. Especially with the situation with the girl and her dad and Yotaro's master and their connection. So hopefully within this 20 something, it's two seasons, of course, only like I think what, 13 episodes each, in this series, hopefully we get a backstory episode on that explaining a lot more, because like even him saying in the last couple minutes, he's like saying, don't die before me, is literally red flagging number one that possibly he is going to die before this show ends. And I'm not talking about our main character, I am talking about his master. So heavily, if he does die, I would rather him die at the last episode in the series and then having his, you know, pupil resume the role. But you know, who knows, hopefully it goes well, we pray. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episode one of Descending Stories. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Saturday for Patreons and next Wednesday for everybody else for episodes 2 and 3. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye!